Well, today was a cool day for all of those weekend events. The marathon actually was pretty decent weather for runners, from what I hear, but cold out on the lakes, and it's going to be a cold Mother's Day coming up tomorrow, too. Temperatures pretty chilly right now. We're in the 40s and low 50s. Actually, cloud cover helping to keep our temperatures from dropping too much from where they were for today. And wind speeds have come down just a bit, especially in the northern and western valley. Still seeing a couple of speeds close to 20 miles per hour in the southern valley out of the north northeast tonight. But the main focus right now is the rain. We have rain that's been lifting northward through the evening hours, and it's now pushing into the southern valley. If we take a closer look at where the heavier rain is occurring right now, right along I-29 west of Wahpeton Breckenridge, a line of showers there. Lightning detection is turned on. Not seeing any lightning popping up with this, just good old-fashioned rain, and it's going to continue moving its way north and eastward. Some rain in Wilkin County and over toward moving into the Pelican Rapids area right now. So this is going to continue moving northeast, and the whole system itself will continue moving northeast, bringing all of us chances for rain over the next couple of days. As we look at our radar satellite composite here, you can see that there's plenty of it. There's a lot of moisture in central South Dakota. The system's still winding up right now, and heavy snow happening in the Black Hills into South Dakota as well. In fact, we have a snowfall report of 8 inches in Hill City already. So heavy, heavy snow falling in the Black Hills, and we have that chance for some snow. Remember, we have that winter storm watch in effect for the Stutsman County area, and that extends down into the winter storm warning in parts of southwestern North Dakota and South Dakota. But here's an overview of what we got going on in the country. Low in eastern parts of Colorado, this is basically touching off the severe storms down to our south and the snow that's happening to our southwest. This will continue moving northeast, and it will continue to bring in that moisture and some instability with it too. So we're dealing with that in the midsection of the country with tornadoes to the south. And another system, our first tropical storm of the season, Anna. 60-mile-per-hour sustained wind gusts as it tries to make landfall on the Carolinas for tonight. Here, we do have some wind coming our way with our forecast, along with some rain, too. As we move into the evening hours again tonight, we saw the rain push in. And overnight, we'll see that rain continue to just lifting into the valley. And by the time we're waking up tomorrow morning, some of it making its way into the northern valley, with more on the way from the south. It's going to be one of those events where we have off and on chances for rain over an extended period. We'll wake up in the morning hours into the 30s and low 40s, but not as chilly as today's sub-freezing lows. That is thanks to the clouds and the rain that's pushing in. By 9 a.m., a significant band of rain showers starts to move into the southern valley, lifting northward toward the Fargo-Moorhead area by lunchtime, and continues to move northward, where you see these yellows and oranges, moderate to heavy rainfall occurring underneath the clouds there. And that'll continue pushing into the northern valley by 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Notice the wind out of the northeast gusting into the mid-30s. So some strong wind with this too. Not a great Mother's Day. Hopefully you don't have any outdoor plans, because it won't be pleasant to be outside. Temperatures are going to be in the upper 40s to low 50s for highs for tomorrow. So another cool day, a windy day, and a very soggy day for our Sunday. Looking ahead toward the afternoon, a little break in the action, and then another round of rain and perhaps even some thunder showers rolls in later tomorrow evening. That'll continue to move northward as well. So several rounds of this will continue to move in. That's tomorrow into Monday, even into Tuesday morning. And what that could mean is some places that see a hefty amount of snow, most likely to south and west, but there's a chance we could get several inches of snow in the James River Valley and a couple of pockets of some light snow off to the east as well. And our rainfall potential with this total liquid moisture is in the several inches range. This orange area, more than 2 inches, some places more than 3 possible. So a very soggy forecast coming up. Tomorrow's high 51. Windy conditions and rainy too, with some storms possible late. And as we look ahead toward the Monday time frame, we see some of that switch over to some snow. And if it's falling at a fast enough rate, some accumulations possible, especially in the morning. We warm up for the end of the week, but unsettled through the extended planner.
It's always a shock to hear that snow word in May, isn't it?
I know, and even a winter storm watch for that matter. So we're going to be dealing with some interesting weather coming up.
Thank you so much, Lisa.
You bet.